Welcome to the third video in the recursion series. So in this video we are going to discuss the problem last index of element in array. So earlier in the previous question we discussed the first index of element in array, and in this problem we are going to discuss the last index. So if element is 8 and this array is given, so the last index of 8 is 3. So the output is 3. Now in the previous question we discussed the three steps, right? So I think you might have remembered all those three steps. So first was base case, second is recursive call, and right, third is small work, right? So first of all, in this question we will be thinking of the recursive call, right? And we know when we are given array we divide the problem, and we usually work on the zeroth index and the rest is given to the recursion. Now recursion will give us the last index and last index of the element, and what we do is we add 1 in that, because the recursion result will be 1 less than the original index. So earlier what we did was, first of all we checked that if arr of 0 is equal to element, right, then just return 0. Earlier in the when we were given first index, we did this, we had this condition first, right? But over here, do you think this condition should be given first? Because if this condition is given first, right, you will see when you will go to 1, it will return the first index only. Like it will return 0, right? So this will not, if we give this condition first, it will not give us the last index. So basically what in this question we'll do, right, let me write this again, 9, 8. 10, 8, right, 0, 1, 2, 3. So what in this question we'll do, first of all, we will keep on dividing. We will keep on dividing our array, right? We will keep on recursive. First, we'll do the recursive calls. First of all, the recursive call will be done on this array, 8, 10, 8, right? Then recursive call will be done on this 10, 8. Then recursive call will be done on this, right? Now, over here, this index will be 0, right? Now, once we get the array, right? Once we get the single element, right? We will check. Now we'll check, right? If the arr 0 is the element, right, now we'll check this condition, then we'll return the index which is 0. We return 0, and then this array, this 10 8 will return 0 plus 1 will be 1, and then 8 10 8 will return 1 plus 1 2, and at last, this is gonna return 2. So 2 plus 1 will become 3. So 8 is at present at index 3. So what is the basic difference from the previous question, first element? In first element, first we, this is the first, right? First index, and over here is the last index 1. So what basically is the difference between two? In the first one, we first check this condition. Why we check this condition first, if array of 0 is equal to element? Because if we encounter that the zeroth index, like suppose 1, 2, 3 and element is 1, right? If we see that at first only our element is present, we will return the zeroth index only. Right, this is the first index, but this could not be the case in the last, right? In the last, we need not to like do like this. If for example, if 1, 2, 3, 1 is the array, so answer should be this index of this one, right? So that's why in the first index problem, we had this condition first and then the recursive call, right? Then the recursive call. But in the last, we need to go till end of the array, right? And whatever answer we get from that, we have to calculate our answer. So here we will do the recursive call first and then we will do the if condition. If arr of 0 is equal to e, right? We will return 0. So basically this is the main difference between first index and the last index. Rest everything is same. So let's see the code and it will be more clear, right? So this is the input given 9 8 10 8, and since we need to find the last index, it will come out to be 3, and the element given is 8. We will be calling function last index of number in array, and we'll be passing array, the length of array and the element. Now in this, first we are going to check the base case that if the size of array is 0, just return -1. We do not find the element, and then we do the recursive call. We are doing the recursive call in which we pass the array, like we will not include the 0th element, and we will pass from first index and reduce one size because we have not included the 0th index element, and passed x. Now this was the recursive call, this was the base case recursive call, and this whole is a small work. Now we get something from the answer, right? If we got something from the answer, it means that the element is present, right? So we'll simply return ans plus 1. But if we got -1, right, means the element was not present in the later part of the array, right? In the recursive part, it was not present. Hence what we'll check is, now we'll check that if at 0th index is that element present. If present, then return 0. That it's present at 0th index, so we return 0. But if it is not even present at 0th index, it means it's not present, so we'll return -1. So this was the small work, right? Just do it for some other test cases. You will better understand. And if you have any doubt, please feel free to comment, and the code link will be present in the description. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching.